Hello and welcome to Loving Tech Life. In this video, I'm going to show you how to connect your PS5 controller to your PC. Stick around to the end for some tips on finding DualSense supported games on Steam. With that said, let's get into it. To begin with, you're going to get your PC ready to pair to the controller by going to Bluetooth settings on your PC. To do this, go to the search bar and type Bluetooth and select Bluetooth and other device settings. Here, it's important to make sure Bluetooth is switched on. If your PC doesn't have Bluetooth, you can add it with a USB dongle. I'll leave a link to the one I use in the description below. Now that you've confirmed that Bluetooth is switched on, you can now select Add Device. Before selecting the Bluetooth option here, you'll put the controller into pairing mode. To do this, you need to hold both the Create and PlayStation buttons. A couple of tips here to avoid problems are to press and hold down the Create button first, and secondly, make sure you're holding both buttons down long enough to see the light start flashing like this. Now that the controller is ready to pair, you can click on the Bluetooth option and a list of devices will show up. The PS5 controller appears as DualSense wireless controller. We go ahead and select this and it will connect and pair with your PC. This pairing step can take a bit of time if you haven't done it before, so wait patiently for it to connect. If you're asked for a PIN number here while pairing the controller, just enter 4 zeros. Select done, and now the PS5 controller appears as DualSense wireless controller in the list of input devices and it shows that it's connected. On the controller itself, it will stop flashing and the light will just be a solid color. Next, head over to Steam. On the top left of the screen, select the Steam menu and choose Settings. Here, you need to look down the list and find and select Controller. In this window, you'll see your PS5 controller listed at the top. Steam has an option to enable and disable rumble, as well as the option to switch to the Nintendo button layout. You can also test your controller inputs by selecting Begin Test and test them out. Steam also has some calibration and advanced settings features, which you'll find in here. Here you can calibrate the analog joystick and gyro. You can even customize the color of the light on your controller. Further down the list, you'll find all the external gamepad settings for different kinds of controllers. The setting we care about in this case are the PlayStation controller support options. With the latest version of Steam here, you'll see there are three different options to choose from: not enabled, enabled in games without support, and enabled. If you select enabled, Steam input will be enabled for every game run from Steam, which has the most compatibility, but you may find that some games will show Xbox buttons and inputs with this setting because it's acting as an Xbox controller. If there is a game that you played previously that had PlayStation buttons in game and the enabled setting changed them to Xbox inputs, then you can select not enabled and the game will switch them back to PlayStation inputs. As of the recording of this video, I recommend choosing enabled in games without support. Steam is surveying developers, and if they specifically respond that the game does not have PlayStation controller support, then Steam input is enabled with this setting and will act as an Xbox controller and show Xbox controller inputs in game. Otherwise, the game will default to using the PlayStation controller and its inputs. If for some reason the controller isn't working, you can fall back to the enabled option. If you want to know more about which games are currently tagged with support for the PS5 controller, there is a new controller-friendly hub on Steam you can check out by going to the store. Under categories, you'll find controller-friendly on the left-hand side. On here, if you scroll down, you'll be able to find the filter for games that support the PS5 DualSense controller. You can also check out what controller support there is available for individual games. Just go to their page and on the right-hand side, you'll see the information under full controller support. Note that with some games, you'll need to connect the controller with a wire to get full controller support with all the features. You can also check controller support from your library. Just select the game and on the right under controller, you'll see if it supports the controller you have plugged in. If you're having any issues connecting your controller after following this guide, then check out the Controller Fix playlist on the card above. I'll also put a link to the playlist in the description below. I will keep adding controller fixes to the playlist, so be sure to subscribe for more. Thank you for watching, and if this video helped you out, please go ahead and smash the like button below, and I'll see you in the next one.